Hi guys, in this tutorial I will show you how to successfully migrate from MemberPress to WooCommerce. So the first thing you'll need to do is to install the WooCommerce plugin and the WooCommerce memberships plugin and the free plugin orders import export for WooCommerce. Now after you installed those plugins, you'll have to go to MemberPress, memberships, eventually you can open them in a new tab. And as you can see, I have three memberships, gold, silver, and bronze. And here, we have to come here in products, all products. Well, I already made them, but you have to create three products called bronze, silver, gold. And if we click edit on bronze, as you can see, they have to be simple product because this tutorial is for non-recurring subscriptions. And as a simple product, you have to check this virtual because you will not ship anything. The regular price and the name. That's pretty much what you have to do with those products. Hit publish. And after you repeat the process for every single membership, then you have to come here in WooCommerce memberships. In this tab, membership plans, and here I already created them, but again you have to create free membership plans, bronze, silver, gold, like in the MemberPress. But the tricky part is that if we click on edit bronze, as you can see, you have to check this product purchase on grant access upon and search for the product that is linked to this membership. In our case, it's bronze. If we search for silver, as you can see, and someone buys silvers, it will grant the bronze access as well. If we are here, I may show you how to recreate the rules from MemberPress because it's a little bit different. Here, if we come here into the MemberPress rules, I did two rules. Actually, I created two rules for this tutorial. And if we go here, back to memberships plan, to the desired memberships where you want to restrict the content, you have to click here on restrict content, add new rule, and here it can be anything, memberships, groups, pages, posts. If you have Learn Dash, it can also be curse and stuff, many more. So select pages and type here the desired pages and hit update and repeat the same process for every membership plan that you have. Now, the problem with WooCommerce is that first we need to import the orders and then the members, because if you import the members first, then the orders, then you have to update the members to link with the orders. So it's better that you import the orders first and afterwards the members. So what we need to achieve this is come here into MemberPress transactions, and here I have only four transactions, but you can have 1,000, 2,000. But nevertheless, export table as CSV. And if we come here, open a new Google Sheets, and here press Control O or Command O, click Upload, upload the file, and from here we will take the data to create this WooCommerce orders file. I already created it, but we can go through it to explain what data should you take to create this. So the first two rows, order ID and order number, should be the same, and we recommend adding them because it will be useful when later on when we will import the members as well. We also recommend that it should be a big number like 5,000, 10,000, 15,000. I choose 5,000. The order date, when the transactions when the transaction was completed, as you, let me show you real quick. Here, created that for the first is John Bronze. The first one is John Bronze, okay, and it was created and on 13 on October 2020. So is the same date. So we have to copy this. Okay, here at status, if you choose to copy it from here, let me show you. As you can see, there is a column here with the status, but here is complete. If you type complete, my bad, in WooCommerce, it must be completed, not complete. It will throw an error if you copy them as complete. Of course, the amount, as you can see from here, you just copy it. This is whatever currency you have set in WooCommerce, pounds, yens, or something like that. I don't know. The payment method, I usually use this one for Stripe, and for PayPal is just PayPal and nothing more. Customer ID, you can find it here in the transactions that we just exported in column H. Okay, then copy it again on the customer user. And here, the customer email, the first name, the last name, you will all find it here. User email, user first name, user last name. And again, you have to copy the email address here in the W column. And now we have to go on the right. The pay date is the same as it with the created app date, so you have to copy them again. And here is the tricky part. This is JSON type data. This is how WooCommerce adds them, but here, be sure that you change the name, the product ID, the product ID, you can find it. Let me show you real quick here in products. So we were looking for gold. So here in gold, product ID is 18. So it's correct. The total should be, and the subtotal should be with two decimals. And that's pretty much it with this file. You click on file, download CSV. And now we have to come here in WooCommerce, order import export. Click on import orders. Upload file and import. So now the orders, let me show you real quick, are imported. And when you import the orders first, the customers are also created. Let me show you. We have three customers because here Mr. Joe Gold purchased both gold and silver. So it's only one customer with two transactions. And now, after you have successfully imported the orders, now we have to import the memberships, actually the members, not the memberships. So I already did the CSV. I had it prepared. But again, we will go through it together. So those two fields should never should be left blanks. The username, you can go here in the transactions file that we just exported, and here in the column D you can find the user login. So those should be copied. Again, member's first name, member last name, member email. Now, membership plan. You have to come here in WooCommerce memberships, memberships plan. And here you will find all the data to fill the membership plan, the membership plan ID, the membership plan slug, and the product ID. So first of all, membership plan, it's actually the name, the title. Membership plan ID, you can find it if you hover on the title down below, it will appear a link, and at the end where it's saying post equal with a number, that's the ID that you are looking for. Okay, so this is the membership plan ID. The membership plan slug, it's is this one, and the product ID, you can find it from products, or you can find it right here, as you can see, 18, 19, 20. Membership status: active, pending, or cancelled. That depends on the CSV. Order ID. This is why I was telling you guys to always add a big number here. So when you are importing the members, you just copy this column right here. And this is the tricky part. The member scene's date should be, you should not take from order date because it's not the same. Because a member can be active for like 2 years, and if you add this this date, it will update the member, and it will that member will lose all the progress that he made on your website for the past 2 years. So that's not okay. So you can come here in users, all users, and you can find the register date here for all users that registered on our website. Then you click on file, download CSV. Now if we go back here, memberships, click on import export tab, click here on import from CSV. Update existing records if a matching user membership is found. Okay, create new user membership is a matching user membership is not found. Upload file and import. Just for the record, if you have like 2 or 3,000 rows, it might take a while, like from 10 to 14 minutes or something. So now if we come here, members, as you can see, we have successfully imported the members, and more important, the members are linked with the correct orders. And if we go here on John Gold and click on edit, as you can see, he has two plans. He has both gold and silver, and both of them are linked correctly. So that's pretty much it. Thank you, guys.